US wenye mko mkitaka hashbacks ni almost on the same class, nataka niwaonyeshe hapa. So kuna Auris, kuna Mazda, kuna Suzuki, zote ziko hapa na ziko mpaka na Subaru, sawa. So I want to show you which one and every of them, tuangalie. Kuna Toyota Auris hapa, hii ni gari iko fiti sana, 1800 cc, kuna ya 2 liter na kuna ya 1500, sawa sawa. So this one is a good vehicle, but the price is always high. This one utapewa na 1.8 bei ya kuongea, sawa sawa, but it's good, inakaa stylish kidogo, but the interior side is a little bit compact. Kuna Mazda Axela petrol all wheel drive, unaangalia this one is a kama ni 2017, hii ni 1.9 million bei ya kuongea because it's an all wheel drive. Ni gari iko fiti, it's a little bit longer than this Auris, but iko poa, it's stylish, I love it. Mimi mwenyewe naweza sema this one is much better than the Auris, but the test lies on you. Ni gani unataka? Look at the front side, angalia the front side, inakalia this one looks haijaoverdo, it looks okay. Kuna headlights, kuna pale indicators, kuna headlight washers, very nice looking grill, alafu ime slope down vizuri, and alafu it's long, which means you get more legroom and headroom. Ukiangalia this Auris over here, Auris ime slope sana from the front, which means kwa mambo ya aerodynamics iko tu sawa. Iko na a lot of chrome finishing, ukiangalia kwa grill iko poa, iko na full LED headlights, iko na daytime running lights. Iko na fog lights pale chini, more plastic cladding, especially hiyo piano black finishing ni plastic kidogo. Iko na some very nice alloys, ipi iko na alloys, lakini naangalia zikai stylish sana. So acha pia tuingie to the interior of both of them, tuangalie which one looks more appealing. Na in the interior ya Auris, unaangalia venye iko poa, this is the door, it looks okay. Design iko poa, iko na piano black finishing hapa, storage space, kuna ka speaker pale. I love this how the rest of the cockpit looks like. Naangalia venye inakaa. We have these very nice looking seats, but they are not leather. I love the steering wheel iko fiti. Lane departure warning, more controls hapa. I love this one doesn't come with cruise control, but if you go for the RS, itakuja na cruise control. Kilometers pale ilikuwa imetonyesha 60,000 kilometers on the dash. Naangalia display venye inakaa. Kama 6 inch infotainment system, AC controllers pale. Your gear lever, storage space kidogo na pale hapo. It looks okay, no complaints at all. Alafu wacha tuangalie sasa the back side tuone. So this the back side, angalia the back side venye iko. I love this door, inakaa black vizuri. Alafu this how it is. Angalia pale katikati, there is a lot of spacing for you. Yeah, so I think this is quite good. Lakini pia tutaangalia Axela, pia tuangalie how the inside and how the back side looks like. So let us start with the front and see. Now this is the front side of this vehicle, naangalia venye kako, kako fiti sana. This plastic fabric kidogo, leather hapa, controls ziko fiti, storage space, a very nice looking speaker. I love this how the cockpit looks like. Yeah, the style is almost the same, but depends on what you want. You have these very nice looking seats. I think the Mazda beats Auris in terms of the seats, but huku kwingine I think it's a draw. Look at the controls hapo, huku hakuna. Then your screen ni kadogo, dash iko fiti, the styling and finishing I think Axela has it. Sawa sawa, but nevertheless they are all the same, no difference at all. Acha tuangalie the passenger side, tuangalie kuko vipi. This is the back side ya Axela, angalia venye kako. Looks good to me pia. Looks okay, but since it's a four wheel, hiyo nini yake inapita pale ndani. So space kidogo kamekuwa consumed na hiyo Axela ikipita pale. Unaangalia huku kwingine, it looks good to me, space is okay, but sasa this one has more boot space as compared to the Auris. Unaangalia Auris kidogo imeslope from the back, but this one here kidogo iko na a lot of boot space. When it comes to lighting, look at the design of the tail lights. Unaangalia iko fiti, kako poa pia, but then Axela pia nao wanakuanga na yao iko more futuristic, but it's a draw, iko fiti. Axela wameenda na chrome finishing on the lower side. This one hakuna chrome finishing. The reflectors, it's plain. Hiyo yao iko na plastic cladding hapo nyuma kidogo. So wameenda na a little bit of styling. Kuna aerial fin hapa juu. This one pia has the same thing. Iko na aerial fin. But on the doors, hii pia unaona iko na chrome finish on the lower side. This one pia has the same chrome finish on the side. Keyless entry for both of them. Angali kama uko na key, you just press here, the door will open. This one, as soon as you have the key na iko karibu naye, you can just access the interior. Sawa sawa. In terms of the side mirrors, side mirrors iko same, as you can see. This one is mounted on the window, but yeah, axilla it's on the body. Sawa sawa. Side mirror iko na this. Kwa axilla turn signals ziko huko chini, but kwa Auris turn signals ziko pale. Alafu pia kwa side mirrors both of them wameka turn signals pale, unaangalia indicator kana blink hapa. Na pia kwa axilla kana blink, but the one in the axilla looks more stylish na hiyo straight line. So I think that one the axilla is more stylish than this one. Kwa Auris sawa sawa, but nevertheless both of them look fine. At the backside indicators ya axilla inawaka katikati, but ya Auris kidogo kanawakia kando. Everyone has their own style, na hivyo ndio venye kuko sawa sawa. I love the finishing. So in terms of parking lights, angalia axilla kako on the side, but this one ya Auris inawasha hadi fog lights na daytime running lights. Angalia Auris has daytime running lights, which in Ankalia a little bit on a higher notch kidogo as compared to the axilla. So angalia from the front, that's when you get to see it properly in Ankalia fit. Look at this, alafu pia look at the headlights na daytime running lights, inakaa poa sana. Sawa, so huko kwa engine, both cars run on 1500cc engines. Both of them have four cylinders, so this is the Mazda Sky Active Technology engine. Yeah, very nice engine. It runs on an automatic transmission. So all Mazdas by the way was run on automatic transmission, 1500cc for both of them. On this side we have Auris in a run on a 1NZFE engine, VVTi. These are CVT transmission. So 1500cc here, very nice looking. Power is almost the same, but in terms of sportiness kale kidogo, because it's an all-wheel drive, that one is a little bit powerful than this one. Sawa sawa. Yeah, the bonnet of this one is a little bit heavy, so sijui kama iko na more protection than this one. Hii inanikalia mbao kidogo, mabati nasikia this one, alafu this one inaka more compact kidogo. Sawa sawa. I want additional feature yenye haiko pale. This one has headlight washers, that one doesn't have headlight washers. Sawa sawa, very nice. Alafu one more difference in terms of price, Auris watakwambia 1.9 million negotiable. Axilla this one, because it's a all wheel drive petrol, watakwambia 2 million negotiable, but in the end it's somewhere on the same page. Sawa sawa. Yeah, I was to compare these two cars with this Subaru Impreza, but I thought I don't know kama Impreza iko na different notch kidogo, but let me do it here, let me show you. You look at the backside. Let's start the price. The price of Subaru Impreza, this one is a 2017 unit, is 1.8 bei ya kuongea. So this one is a little bit cheaper. It is a all-wheel drive, as you know, kawaida Subaru inakujanga na symmetrical all-wheel drive. The taillights sasa hapa ndio zinaka design fit sana. Look at those the taillights. You have your brake light pale, sorry, your reverse lights, alafu kuna indicator light, brake lights zako ziko hapo katikati, inaka fiti. On the lower side it has more of a plastic bumper. Sawa sawa. On the side profile, this one looks a little bit longer, so of course it has more room in terms of leg room pia. Sawa, for both the driver and the passenger. On the lower side uko na alloy wheels pale. I think that's standard in all these cars. The side mirror haina turn signals on it, of which the other two cars had. Yeah, wameka hapa on the side. Sawa sawa. On the front side, let me show you how the Subaru looks like. Angalia kanaka longer kidogo, the bonnet has more space. Look at the front side, iko na LED headlights, iko na daytime running lights, iko na turn signals hapo on the side, iko na fog lights chini, iko na more plastic cladding, iko na headlight washers, of which the Auris ndio iko na headlight washers. A very nice looking grill, kako fiti, alafu iko na line of chrome kidogo hapo. Sawa sawa. The front bumper looks good. Headlight washers. Acha tuingie ndani tuangalie the difference between this one and the other two. It's a keyless entry pier, but now you get this door that has different accents. You have like this plastic here, we have a fabric finishing, we have this plastic pier yenye I think walikuwa wanajaribu copy carbon kidogo. Unaangalia hizi is coffee controls on the door, chrome finishing on the door handles, more storage for you, your speaker. I love the cockpit, looks good. Cockpit yake ina nikalia fiti. Of the three, I think I'll take the cockpit of this vehicle. Unaangalia venye iko poa. The display, especially at night, looks amazing. Pale uko na display ya kukuonyesha more about your fuel consumption na nini. Alafu iko na very nice looking screen. Climate controls iko poa. Your gear lever is nice. kuna storage compartments hapa especially for your cup holders. Alafu you have this very nice looking door here. Sorry, seats. Look at these seats. The seats look nice. I think in these three cars, I think this one beats all of them. The downside about this one is that it's a key ignition. The other one ilikuwa push to start, both of them. Cruise control setup iko hapa, controls for your infotainment system. So I think Subaru has almost everything. Alafu in terms of safety, Subaru beats all this because of the Subaru EyeSight technology. On the top side, you have a number of things. As you can see, traction control, a lane departure assist, alafu pre-collision monitoring system hapo. The rest of the dash inanikalia poa. Look at that, looks amazing. Alafu uko na viti zako ziko poa sana. Let us look at the back side, tuangalie the spacing. At the back side, you have this very nice looking door. Uko na leather finish hapa, control kidogo. Then you have this backside yenye inanikalia fiti. Look at that leg room. The leg room is fine, it's enough. Kale kaniniwa kanapita pale ya four wheel drive, driving shaft. Alafu kungine uko poa. And then you get a ton of space at the back. So I think Subaru has more space at the back side, sindio? As compared to the other two. So just like the other two, this Subaru Impreza runs on a 1500cc engine. Kuna option ya 1600 na pia kuna another option ya 2 liter sawa. So this car runs on a 4-cylinder engine. This is a flat 4, as you can see. This for Subaru and majorly runs on a CVT transmission sawa. So two of them are CVT, the Auris and the Impreza. I love the Mazda has an automatic transmission sawa. So all these cars ziko fiti, but I think Subaru beats all these three in terms of price kwa sababu ni 1.8 kuongea. That was 1.9 bei ya kuongea na this one is 2 million bei ya kuongea. Sawa sawa. So it's you now to choose which one you want. Alafu the good thing is that all of the three of them are in white. Alafu zote ziko na black interior. So the only difference ni bei. Sawa. But CVT, yeah, CVT, unajua mambo CVT ya Subaru, CVT ya Toyota na Mazda wana CVT au kuna automatic transmission. So wewe mwenyewe utachoose kama unataka CVT ya Subaru or you want CVT ya Mazda. Sawa sawa. So guys, tell me what you think in the comment section. Niambie gari gani imekubamba, kama either ni hii hapa Auris ama utachukua Mazda or you'll take the legendary Subaru. Sawa sawa. Thank you so much guys. Make sure you subscribe to Adeke Auto Trading. You get more cars, more reviews. Alafu tuone venye kutaenda sawa. Show more support by subscribing to my channel. Next time we'll do other videos to upload to our channel so that you get to see more. Thank you so much for watching.